Simon & Schuster Audio presents Wedding Hacks, 500 plus ways to stick to your budget, stay stress-free, and plan the best wedding ever by Maddie Eisenhart. Read by Tanis Parenteau. Introduction. Congratulations, you're engaged! Now it's time to settle in and plan this party. While a wedding might be cause for celebration, the planning process isn't always confetti cannons and champagne toasts. Luckily, Wedding Hacks is here to help you create an amazing big day. Wedding Hacks is designed to be your pocket wedding planner, combining more than 500 insider tips with practical advice for keeping your cool in the face of impractical expectations, family drama, and financial realities. This book will take you step by step through the planning process, from celebrating your engagement to kicking back on your honeymoon, saving you time, money, and stress along the way. You'll also learn how to avoid common wedding planning mistakes that could come back to haunt you later. With Wedding Hacks, the planning process is covered from start to finish, so no matter where you are in your timeline, you can jump right in and get the advice you need. So grab your partner and let's hack your way to the best wedding ever. Chapter 1. Organizing your budget and to-do list. 1. Wait a minute before you plan. It's tempting to jump right into booking a venue and picking your outfits the minute you're engaged. But hold off on making any major decisions until you have some big conversations with your partner and families about budgets and expectations. You can't book a venue if you don't know how much you're spending. And you'll want to know in advance if any of your parents have unspoken expectations about the formality or size of your wedding. They don't necessarily get to dictate those details, but their opinions will factor into your planning one way or another. 2. Prepare yourself for sticker shock. The weddings we've seen in movies and TV are incredibly expensive. Most of them feature details that cost more than your whole catering budget. So one of the first reactions you're likely to have while wedding planning is sticker shock. It's helpful to remember that unrealistic expectations aren't your fault. Those on-screen weddings seemed so reasonable. And sticker shock is normal. Start planning armed with this information, and you're less likely to get your hopes up about the affordability of a 5-tiered wedding cake. 3. Say no. Most wedding traditions aren't that traditional at all. You'd be surprised how many are pop culture or marketing inventions. So eliminate anything that isn't essential. Take a pause before making any major wedding planning decisions and ask yourself, is this really what we want? And give a hard no to anything that doesn't fit. 4. Research real wedding budgets. One of the most useful tools when you're trying to plan a wedding is seeing how other couples did it first. Reddit's Weddings Under 10K forum and apracticalwedding.com's Real Weddings both share detailed breakdowns of wedding budgets and how each couple pulled things off. Even if the wedding isn't in your area, it's helpful to know that an ultra-chic $3,000 wedding included a free venue, gifted photography, and a thrift store dress. 5. Rethink wedding. If you're planning a wedding for less than $10,000, adjust that number for regional differences in wedding costs. The best thing you can do is reset your expectations around what a wedding should look like. A seated dinner in a fancy ballroom? Probably not going to work. But a family-style taco bar at your favorite park? Now we're talking. And creativity can extend beyond your venue. A morning wedding with a breakfast buffet and mimosas will set you back significantly less than a steak and potatoes dinner and can be just as fun. 6. Set your priorities and then stick to them. Sit down with your partner and make a list of your most important wedding priorities. That might include having as many guests as possible, serving the best food and drinks, or throwing an epic party. Then keep your eye on that prize. When you're having a minor meltdown later about the cost of flowers, ask yourself if having a Pinterest-worthy floral spread was one of your priorities. If it wasn't, let it go. Find an affordable alternative or forget it altogether. 7. Avoid the detail trap. It's easy to get distracted by all the wedding day details. Decor, outfits, pictures. But think about the weddings or events you've been to. Do you remember the centerpieces? The menus? The clever sign at the entrance? Probably not. What makes a great event is more ethereal than those things. It's about people, energy, and a moment in time. When you feel yourself getting stressed about the cost of centerpieces, remember that details are not what make a wedding memorable. 8. Pick your battles. Parental expectations can be a major source of wedding planning stress. Remember that your parents and grandparents have probably been thinking about your wedding long before you even met your partner. While that doesn't mean they get a free pass, try to cut them some slack and pick your battles wisely. If something really matters to your family and you only care about it a little bit, give them a win. But know when to hold firm. Protect your values, maintain your boundaries, and don't be a doormat. 9. Don't make money assumptions. Outdated expectations around who will pay for your wedding don't take into account the reality of your or your parents' bank balances, so have a frank conversation with any invested parties. If asking for money is stressing you out, start with a lower stakes question. Do you have any expectations for our wedding? You can then follow that up with, were you planning on contributing financially in any way? 10. Use your hobbies as inspiration. Feeling uninspired by the average wedding? Think about what you and your partner do in your spare time or on the weekends, and then consider how you could incorporate that into your wedding. Are you beer and pizza people? Or are you more likely to be hitting up the local art gallery scene? Do you love arcades? Any or all of these can be the starting point for figuring out what you want your wedding to look and feel like. 11. Cross it off before you start. Most online wedding checklists are filled with line items for weddings with six-figure budgets, and a lot of it is optional. If you sign up for an account somewhere like thenot.com, take advantage of the trash can icon and delete anything that doesn't feel authentic to you and your partner. For example, are you planning on ordering invitations online? No? Then you don't need to meet with invitation designers first, so trash that item. 12. Build your budget from your savings account. Trying to figure out how much wedding you can afford? Calculate your average monthly savings, or how much you can save if you're being frugal, then multiply that by the length of your engagement. Boom! You've got a rough idea of what you can personally afford to spend on your wedding. 13. Budget your energy. Money is not the only finite resource in your budget. Your energy, physical and emotional, matters too. So make your energy budget as fixed as your financial one. Assign yourself 100 energy points to spend throughout the planning process and use them wisely. Are you going to spend 20 hours researching venues? That's 5 energy points. Just like regular budgeting, you'll have to adjust your expectations when you run out of energy, and you'll be glad for it later. 14. Don't start by cutting the guest list. Every piece of budget wedding advice under the sun will tell you to cut your guest list to save money. And it makes sense. Your costs go up as your guest list goes up. But only be ruthless with your guest list if you want to have a smaller wedding. Or if you're inviting people out of obligation instead of joy. Otherwise, think about who you want at your wedding and plan a celebration you can afford around that number. It may mean getting creative with your catering or hosting it in a non-traditional venue, but the energy of your wedding will be dictated by who is partying with you, not the entree. 15. Do the math. It's common to look at the price tag for an all-inclusive venue or package wedding deal and think, I could do that for way cheaper. And while you probably can, you want to do the real math before you make that call. Between renting furniture, hiring servers, and coordinating the logistics, an a la carte wedding can end up being more expensive, and that's not including time spent pulling it all together. 16. Buy a wedding book and planner. You can find almost everything you'll need to know about wedding planning on the internet. But sifting through search results to find relevant information can take forever. Physical wedding planners and books, like this one, take all that information and condense it into the most useful bits of advice.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.